Hello and welcome to Versus Live. I'm Ross Merriam.
And I'm Corey Baumeister.
And we've got a Rob in the booth. Say hi, Rob.
Hi, Rob.
Rob will be taking all of your questions, comments, concerns, and burns in the chat. Make sure to tag at Star City Games so he can see them and send his favorites over to us. Welcome back in the year of our Lord 2021.
Yes.
Brand new year. Hopefully things are going better, right? Everything's been great so far.
Everything
this year?
In 2021 has been great so far.
Yeah, nothing but good news and blue skies. It's definitely not snowing outside right now.
No, we don't have blue skies right now, but we got blue decks. That's the best we got.
That's the important part. And even more importantly, we have decks featuring cards from Kaldheim. The upcoming expansion preview season started yesterday, so that's why we delayed the show by a day so we could get those cards into decks, start showing you some juicy new brews as soon as possible, because that's how much we love you. We came into work on a Friday. Do you know the last time I did work on a Friday? I think it was my freshman year of college. Do you know when that was? That's like 1984.
Yeah, no kidding. You had to actually pedal your car still to school, right? Mm-hmm. Like,
I had to
Rubble
walk.
Was next
I
to
had
you?
To walk uphill in the snow both ways.
Both ways, that's right. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. All that Californian snow you hear about.
Yes. Yeah. Claremont, California, well known.
Makes sense. Makes sense. Yeah, that is how much we love our audience. You know, coming in on Friday and just getting to play some of these sweet
new braved
magic
the
cards.
Blizzard outside. Absolute blizzard conditions. It's definitely not half an inch of snow that's dusting the, grass.
It was downpouring snow when I walked in the building, so by now it is probably completely melted. That's what I've noticed being in the South now instead of North Dakota. It'd be there for 4 months or 5 years. Who really knows?
But we do have Kaldheim cards and Kaldheim decks for today.
Yes. And I'm pumped.
Oh, yeah. There's some cool ones. I like the way I feel like a few years ago, or maybe 5-10 years ago, preview season used to be a lot more spread out. And so you'd only get a trickle of cards each day, like a couple. And so take a while to have enough to start, brewing decks. Now it's pretty condensed. We get everything in about a week and a half.
Yeah.
And so every day you get a really nice chunk of the set. And you can start sinking your teeth into it pretty quickly.
You know, that brings up, I think I used to rush home from school, uphill, of course, back in the day. I used to
North
rush
Dakota,
home from
famous
school.
For having a lot of hills.
Everywhere. Hills constantly everywhere. Yeah. The great mountains of North Dakota is their saying. Yeah. But I would rush home and I remember having to click on articles.
Rush more home?
I rush more home. Very nice. Wrong Dakota. Yeah. But I remember you had to just open an article and there'd be one card. How big of a deal each card was per day. They wrote whole articles about it. Now it's just tweet it, just tweet it. We'll
send
be
it on the Twitter and we'll be we'll get it.
Or now, we have metal bands previewing our cards. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, I believe that was Rob's direct request to Watsi that they have fulfilled just for him.
It was
nice.
So if you were also enjoying the metal bands, you can thank Rob for that personally.
Yes, absolutely.
It was like the letter campaign from Shawshank, just two a day.
He wrote the letter in his own blood to be as metal as possible. That's what really sold it.
Wow, that is pretty metal of you, Rob. Great work. You got some pull around here.
At least I think it was fun.
Like Ross was saying, today we are going to be playing Standard here, and we had 47 cards to work with. So there's more cards being previewed today, so we didn't get a chance to play with those, of course, because we did plan the show yesterday, but we've still got plenty to work with. The last time, last week that we got to do Kaldheim, we had six or seven. So it was tough to even build shells. But now we're really going to see some decks emerge through some of these cards here.
Yep. The card we are really heavily featuring in this first match is going to be Behold the Multiverse, a card that both Corey and I are very high on.
Agreed.
This to me is one of the best cards previewed thus far. I think.
Yeah, it's a common.
Yeah, it's it looks like it's another card in the vein of Chemist's Insight, Glimmer of Genius. This four mana draw two with a little bit extra added on, but I think this is the best in that group of cards that we've seen so far.
I think so too. Yeah.
You get the scry too, which is really nice. You can dig four cards deep, but that foretell is the real kicker. It looks a little bit unassuming, right? It's nice that the foretell cost plus the two you pay for foretell adds to the normal cost. So you're not paying any extra to split it up. But it's really powerful to be able to split up when you pay for the spell, because when you're playing a reactor deck, which is what these kind of cards want to go in, they want to be paired with 3-mana counter spells, 2-mana yeah. counter spells, and some removal, maybe flash creatures and stuff to finish out the game, and Shark mm-hmm. Typhoon. You know, when you're playing that style of deck and you have a lot of counter spells, you need to line up your answers appropriately, because if something sneaks through, you might be left with a handful of counters that don't do anything anymore.
Exactly.
And yeah. so how you utilize your mana becomes really important, because if you tap down low, you know, and your opponent resolves something at instant speed, or, you know, you have to tap down on your main face or something to hit a land drop, then, you know, you're leaving yourself vulnerable. So yeah. the versatility in how you sequence and how you use your mana is really valuable in the kinds of decks that this goes into.
Totally agree. And speaking of different decks that this goes into, we're playing quite different style decks. I'm definitely more of the tap out Azorius control deck that we kind of saw popular right before Teamer Adventures kind of took over that deck, you know, quite a while ago when Theros Beyond Death was coming out. And you're doing it in a deck that I do think is going to be a better shell for it.
Yeah.
Where you are this deck that's acting all at instant speed. 2-mana counter spells scream out like just insane to me with this card. Like, you know, foretelling that on turn 2 or 3, and then turn 4, like Essence Scatter plus this. Yeah. It seems like if you can do that and then untap with a you know, a board that's at parity, you're going to be pretty far ahead. For me, it's just card, you know, card advantage, card manipulation to curve out, find an answer, find an ECD or yeah. something.
And even in your deck, being able to split the cost lets you curve out more effectively.
Agreed.
So even without the reactive nature of my deck, which I think I agree makes the card at its best, mm-hmm. it still seems powerful enough to want to play.
Agreed. But forget about this card, okay? It's a common. Nico Aris is the card I want to talk about for a little bit, because I'm going to be featuring Nico Aris in two different shells today, because I have a lot of faith in the card, but I want to see how it does in each role. I think this is going to be the lesser of the two as far as how good the card is going to be. In a control role, you can still, you know, kill a creature when it comes down. That's kind of step one for me for Planeswalker being good, is defending itself.
Yep.
You know, Narset is probably the exception, because that is a card that doesn't defend itself, but it's still busted. But being able to downtick, dealing 2 to something in the standard metagame doesn't seem insane to me. So that is the one thing I'm a little wary about, but I do have some high hopes for this.
You can pick off Brushfire Elementals. Yeah. You can pick off, you know, an early Scavenging Ooze.
Yeah, yeah.
Skyclave Apparitions.
There's going to be a lot of untapped innkeepers against against this deck, I imagine, against a blue-white deck.
And, you know, with Behold the Multiverse, if you've got one of these sitting in the Fortell in exile and you play Nico Aris and later untap with it, you can spend 2 mana, draw 2 extra cards, and now you're dealing 6. Now you've got to hit Lovestruck Beasts and, you know, even Feasting Troll Kings.
Yeah.
Although that one has Vigilance, so hard to tap that one.
And another cute thing, now that you say that I just realized now, I mean, even if you have 6 mana, you play this for 1, sack the clue. We're going to be cluing today.
Yeah. Sack the shard.
Sack the shard. And then, you know, you're dealing 4 to something.
Yeah. So it's not that hard to skill up.
Yeah.
I think 4 gets you, again, Questing Beast has Vigilance. I think you might run into a bigger problem of creatures all having Vigilance and them needing to be tapped.
That's true. That's true.
Then actually, because, you know, you draw enough cards, you also have Dream Trawlers. So plenty of ways to pump up that ability and make sure it scales and kills bigger threats. But
absolutely. Absolutely.
I agree with you. You're not maximizing it in the shell.
But I will be maximizing it for deck 3. Deck 3 is my spoiler, is the deck that I really think is going to be quite busted. But we'll save that for a little bit later.
You don't quite use the plus one that well, though. Bouncing Skyclave Apparition can be good.
Yeah, exactly. Skyclave and this, I think, are going to be best buds. You know, Yorian is going to be another thing that's going to be pretty good with it. Shocking. I found a card that interacts well with Yorian. So last card from my deck that's going to be new is Ulrin's Epiphany. Just a time walk here. I'll be able to get you a little bit with 2 Fortell cards here. But
you actually get to play the Morph Mind game.
Exactly. So I do think this this card's going to be pretty good as well. Now, this matchup, I don't think these cards are really going to shine that much, because you are a control deck. But, you know, we'll find out.
Yeah, you know, if you can resolve them, they're really good.
Yes.
And Nico Aris in particular is nice, because it's going to be good no matter how much mana you have. So you could double spell with it at 3, or later in the game when you know I'm depleted, you can just max out into it.
And
so
we've seen stuff like this that scales be very, very good when you don't expect it to be. You know, Stoneclaw Serpent had its time in the sun when Teferi was running around because it scales so well. You know, all these green decks that have Hydras that scale up and stuff, Hydroid Crisis, that kind of scaling effect is usually very undervalued. And that's what I think this card is going to be as well. It's a busted 3-mana Planeswalker that adds some extra value going forward. Yeah. So I have high hopes. But yes, I've been so wrong before.
I am also, that's a card that, you know, actually talked about last night on the podcast. And, you know, it is a difficult card for me to evaluate on the surface because there's so much going on with it.
Yeah.
But my instinct is it's good.
My instinct is it's very good, too. But I also thought Oko was very medium. So I don't think my opinion should be trusted. Yeah. So
my last new card is Frostbite, just the latest removal spell. So I'm only playing Snow Basics to go with it. No other permanents. So just another nice card to have because it gives you mana flexibility when you're being reactive. You know, on turn 3, I can use that to deal with an early creature and maybe finish foretelling a Behold the Multiverse.
Yeah.
You know, so just really stressing that when you're playing a reactive deck, having the most mana efficient and being the most mana efficient is really important.
And that's one card that normally I would not be afraid of in this matchup, but all it screams to me is Skyclave Apparition stock is going to go way down if red becomes, you know, it plays those a decent amount, snow red, you know. I still think Skred is much better, so we'll stick with that one, but
yeah.
All right, I was the first Kaldheim championship, so it's up to you to answer back.
Well,
I was the true Viking. You got to see if you can...
The original Viking?
The original Viking.
Okay.
Okay, well, this hand is quite awkward in a, what to be assumed, a control mirror, essentially.
Yeah, I also do not have a good hand for the control mirror.
Yeah.
four red cards. I'm going to send this one back.
Yeah, I think I'm going to send this one back, too. Yeah. That one's... both our decks were very prepared for creature decks, I can see.
The good news for my side is I'm playing 2 Soulseer, 4 Bone Crusher, and 3 Frostbite in the main.
Yeah.
And the only ones that are you know... The only ones I really want to side out are the Frostbites.
Yeah.
Because the Bone Crusher is the least a threat. A couple Soul Seers is nice to have against maybe Dream Trawler or Nico or some sort of Planeswalker.
Yeah. And I have Apparition, Shatter, and Glass Casket. And, Casket is okay against Sharks, but, you know, hitting the adventure creatures when you can bounce them and stuff, I think my removal is a lot worse than yours.
Yeah.
Because your removal is also creatures, which is messed up. All right, let's try this again.
It's the benefit you get when you play mountains.
Yeah, very true.
Your things tend to deal damage.
All right, I get a keeper.
Keeper, that's lucky.
I know. Okay, I'm going to bottom this land, this extra land here.
And I, too, have a keeper.
All right, bring it on. Kaldheim kicks off now.
Snow-covered island.
Okay. Okay, that's a good one. Let's go with a Triome Tap and pass to you.
Snow-covered mountain.
All right. Don't you just love snow-covered lands? I swear I remember hearing a rant where they're your favorite. Is that correct?
They're not my least favorite.
Okay, pass to you.
That's all I'll say. Castle Vantress.
Okay, Is that a snow-covered Vantress?
No, it is not.
Oh, that's too bad. All right, I got an 0/4 wall. It's going to be very important. Your only creature that attacks on the ground is a 4-powered creature.
I can attack with a 2/2 Crawling Barons.
All right, the first new action, foretell. So I don't have to show you it or anything, right?
Yeah, face down.
All right, so then I'll play a temple. this card is not bad. All right, we'll keep it. Pass to you.
I'll play a Brazen Bar around here. So,
okie dokie.
Let's get the beatdown started.
Zabits.
Attack for 3.
All right, I'll take it. 17.
Pass the turn.
Up to 19. Okay, I have a Skyclave Apparition.
I'll counter that.
Okay, that's rude. And I have an Amirius Call tapped and passed to you.
Attack for 3.
16.
Pass the turn.
Untap.
First one to miss a land drop. Mm-hmm. Not great.
I will go with an ECD.
I will counter that.
All right, pass to you. I've been in this situation before where I'm the tap out control deck and I just jam and never hit.
Attack for three.
Okay.
13.
13.
Pass the turn.
All right. Let's see. Let's go with Skyclave Apparition.
Resolves.
Get that out of there. And I'm going to play this as this and pass to you.
On your end step, I'll play a Brazen Borrower.
Okay. Rude.
Oh, will I do that? Actually.
Seems like you just did.
Let's do this differently.
Okay.
I'm going to bounce the wall.
Okay.
And then stomp the apparition.
How dare you?
That seems way better.
That does seem better.
That seems so much better. Okay, you still get a 3-3 attacking. This is just exiled.
There's going to be so many zones.
Yeah.
All right.
Attack for three.
I will take it down to 10.
Then I will play a Temple of Epiphany. Scry one. Leave that on top.
Okay.
And pass the turn.
All right, end step. I will play the first new card.
I was hoping it was the Time Walk.
Oh, yeah. It resolves, I assume, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I don't want either of those. Draw two. Untap. Draw. All right. Well, we only really have one somewhat decent play, and I will play an ECD.
So all that's going to do is not exile anything.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to return a Skyclave Apparition in two turns.
Yep.
Yeah, that resolves.
Okay. Chapter one, and then I will foretell this. Pass to you.
Okay. On your end step, I'll play Brazen Borrower.
Okay.
Play Crawling Barrens. Attack for six.
Okay, I'll go to four.
And pass the turn.
All right. Chapter two?
Yep.
Well, guess I'm just dead if I don't do something. So, I will play this as the other side.
Get yourself a nice new pathway.
Yep.
Shiny Azorius pathway.
All right, this time I got the Time Walk.
Okay, I will play five mana for a neutralize.
Oh, well, then I lose.
I could have had a glass casket.
Yeah, no, good. I don't. Needed that to resolve, and then I'd have a pretty nice sequence set up with some blockers. But yeah, I mean,
yeah,
just
that was my last counter spell. So,
yeah.
That's the classic tempo game plan.
Exactly. Yeah, I think this matchup is going to be slightly rough game one for me, but we got some counter spells and some sharks on the board.
When you look at that game from the outside, I did everything I wanted to do, countered every relevant spell you played, and won the game before you got to resolve anything relevant.
Yeah.
But if you actually look at the end state, Corey was very close to turning that game around.
You just had one more counter?
That neutralized the last one.
Yeah.
I was drawing a Jawari Disruption, but I don't think that was going to counter much at that point.
Probably not. Yeah. And then I did have gas in the tank, so I was very close to taking over.
I did have a Behold the Multiverse left, and the Crawling Barrens is pretty good, but
Crawling Barrens is going to be a nice one.
I've only got the one.
Oh, really?
Only one.
I swear you drew it every game in our practice games, too. Anyways, that's going to do it for our very first game.
Funny how that works.
That's going to do it for our first game here of our special Friday Kaldheim Standard Edition. We are going to head to sideboarding. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. All right, everybody. Welcome back to Versus Live, where we are sideboarding between Azorius Control and Is It Flash? From my end, we're taking out just a ton of the white cards here. Skyclave Apparition, as most tap-out control decks are. You usually have a lot of removal just because you have to for game one if you do play against, Gruul Adventures, any kind of aggressive deck like that. So taking out Skyclave, Shatters, Glass Casket, and then a couple of the two expensive blue cards, thinking that there's going to be disputes coming in. Bringing in our own set of sharks, Brazen Borrowers, Disputes, Negates. Now I'm trying to basically play the same game plan as you and just hope that works out for me.
And I'm, doing something very similar, cutting a lot of my removal spells, a couple Essence Scatters for better counter spells. I also have a couple Maze Mind Tomes so I can get some early card advantage in, cheap card advantage, and make sure I hit my land drops because that's going to be really important.
All right, let's do it. And Rob, you got any questions from our lovely audience?
Got a fresh one that just came in. Ooh, Leo, the Magic Man.
Fresh out the kitchen.
Fresh out the kitchen.
What do you think the best cards previewed so far are?
Best cards previewed, I still think, is probably Showdown of the...
Showdown of the Scalds?
Showdown of the Scalds. I still have the highest hopes for that card. Just, it looks too much like Escape the Wilds to me to not be busted. But I also think that triple green card, I think, is pretty insane, too. Like, that feels like a pretty pushed card. Old Man Trials. Old Growth Dryad. Something yeah, like that. I should be better with these names, but...
Old growth
troll, I think.
Dryad, yeah. troll of the,
troll of the old dryad.
We're as proven based on our history, we are very good at remembering card names.
Yeah. Very good. To
Growing
be fair, we're
dryads
one day
in the undergrowth of trolls.
Now we're still probably going to be saying it like this 3 weeks from now. Then it'll be bad, but we only had one day, yep. So yeah.
So I like Showdown. I like Behold the Multiverse a lot, and yeah. I like Tybalt quite a bit. I think that card's very good. I think the Planeswalker side is very powerful, mm-hmm. and the fact that you get to play a lot of copies of it because you can play it early as the God side,
yeah.
Really helps out. I think that's a double faced card where the two mesh really well because they cover each other's weaknesses.
Yep. No, I think that's cool too. And I love the synergy of the blue 2/3 flyer Scald of the... God dang it.
I think it's Haka and Alrund.
Yeah, I like the synergies in a blink deck, and I think that would be cool, but I don't think by any means that's one of the most powerful cards, but there's a lot of cards that I see that have some hope. And I also really want to try to make the new blue-black saga work that just got spoiled today with, Birth of Miletus and an Esper Shell. Like, you can have this, I'll take Lovestruck Beast, I think that would be fun. And then blink it with Yorion after you've exchanged some control of some stuff. I think that would be pretty sweet as well.
Yeah. There's definitely some cards that are going to be strong role players. But as far as cards that really are
just powerful,
pulling you in a certain direction, those three are my top picks. Showdown, Behold the Multiverse, and Tybalt or Valky.
Yeah.
Whatever the Loki. I'm just going to call it Loki.
Loki, yeah. And I do have some hope Loki, for the 6-mana green Phyrexian God that they spoiled right at the end there.
The Praetor.
I should say the 5-mana 6/6 because Castle Garenbrig and that are just besties, know?
I love the idea of having the 3-drop and then they kill it and you get the enchantment. Then you play Castle and you immediately have 6-mana on turn 4.
Okay. I like that. See, I like it with... I like to go bigger. I want to have Yorvo in play, and then I want to play that, and I want to get... Do you get 4 counters? I think you get 4 counters, because you would double it if the creature has higher power, but then this card doubles it itself. Because Yorvo, the text says, if the power is bigger than the other creature, you double it, but then this card...
What is the text on Yorvo exactly?
I got it. So that is, spoiler alert,
depends how exactly how Yorvo is worded.
Yeah.
So Yorvo says, whenever another green creature does a battlefield, put a +1/+1 counter on Yorvo. Then if its creature's power is greater than Yorvo's power, put another one. So you actually won't get the second instance because it'll already be a 6/6 because you got 2 counters because of the ability on Vorinclex. So Vorinclex doubling the counters prevents the second ability, so you only get 2.
Okay. Well, still sweet. Wait, so it actually does nothing. It's just a 6/6. It would do the same if you played Crawworm right after Yorvo.
It's just Colossal Dreadmaw, which we know is the best card ever printed.
Exactly. Okay, great question, y'all. Keep them coming in. I'm going to go first here, try to have a little better luck this game.
You mean a little better skill?
No, I meant better letter... That's what I meant. All right, I'll keep.
Same.
I will play a castle and pass to you.
I will play a temple and scry.
What'd you draw this turn?
I will scry this temple to the bottom.
Okay. I will untap. I will play this land and pass to you.
Island, Maze Mind Tome.
Okay.
Pass turn.
I have an omen. Okay, so I really want this top card so I can have a nice play next turn, but I do not want the other land. So I'll draw this, untap, draw this.
Have a Nico?
I do have a Nico. This is going to be fun. All right, so Nico. Now I think I want to... So here's the thing. If I create a shard now, you can just stomp it.
Stompy.
But you could go land Soulseer it as well. I think I would rather get some value out of it, so I'm going to go with a clue and pass to you.
Okay. I will scry on your instep.
Okay. I mainly just really want to have something to do with my mana next turn. So I don't really care if Nico goes away. It's kind of already a 2-for-1 if you were to kill it. Kind of like Narsa. You know, you get a card out of it and then they kill it. That's just a natural 2-for-1.
I'm gonna bottom that.
Okay.
Let's just draw. I will play an island and pass the turn.
All right.
This game going so far a lot better for Corey.
Yay! All right, I will get another shard. We're going to use clues for now because naturally we do not have shards yet. And then I will play a land and pass to you.
On your end step, I will cycle Shark Typhoon for one.
Shark Typhoon for one? Okay.
I have a 1/1 shark.
Okay.
I will then scry.
Okay, I like that.
I will leave that on top.
Nice wasted scry.
Go to my turn?
Yep.
I will attack Nico.
I will respond by sacking this. I do want to draw this, so that's fine. And yeah, maybe I should have ticked up Nico to play around the sharks. Maybe that was my bad.
Okay, I'll play River Glide Pathway and pass the turn.
All right, I'll sack this as well.
Okay. Glad Corey did not have his own Shark Typhoon there.
Yeah.
That's what I was really worried about, but I had to try to kill the Nico.
Yep. No, I don't blame you.
And there's never going to be a point where, you know, I get to make a shark and Corey can't eat it unless he misses a land drop, which is not something I'm going to be banking on when he's drawing cards with shards.
Yep. All right, I'm going to go for a sad ECD.
Sad ECD. Well, I'm going to be even sadder because that's going to resolve.
Okay, your go.
I do have a multiverse on your end step, though.
Okay. Way to not foretell it. Smart.
Couldn't let you know what was happening.
Yes.
Okay, we'll put one on the bottom and one on top.
Okay.
Draw that one and an extra one.
Lucky.
Play a River Glide Pathway.
Okay.
Attack you for one.
19.
And how do I want to play this turn? You got 6 in hand?
I have 6. All good.
Now the game is getting interesting.
Very.
Very interesting.
You got infinite cards, huh?
Yep. I am going to bounce the ECD.
Okay. Rude.
Then I will pass the turn.
Okay. Untap. Draw. I will go with land and try it again.
It will resolve again.
Pass to you.
Now with that ECD out of the way, let's play the borrower.
I got a dispute.
Okay. That's fine.
Just want to try to put myself in a position where I make your counter spells rough, try to get back Nico.
Attack for one.
18.
Play a mountain.
Okay.
And pass the turn.
Okay. Draw. Trigger. Your counter spells cost a little bit more, but you don't really mind right now. Okay, let's see what kind of turn I want to have here.
Right now we are settling in for a long game.
Yeah.
We both made all our land drops. Nobody's super far ahead on the battlefield. We all both have 6 cards in hand.
Yep, this is going to be a grind. All right, let's go with... My play is not very strong this turn. Not very strong at all. All right. Actually, we are going to try to make a good play this turn. So I'm going to take 3.
Brings you to 50.
And I'm going to play an Amiri's Call. Try to get some angels. Angels can still have all your counter spells. The tax is not doing too much to you this turn.
Well, don't have a counter spell in my hand.
That's good. That's good.
Do I simply make the play I was planning on, or do I try to... I can try to see if I have a counter in my top two cards, but it can't be neutralize or dispute.
Top two? Okay. Not sure how you do that.
I don't think that's going to be worth it, so I think I just have to let that resolve.
All right. Ari Lax is coming to play then, and I'll pass to you.
And then... Oof, this is going to be hard. Corey took a pretty big risk there, and it paid off. Do I want to do this now? Because that is going to...
What you got there, Ross? Just going to play another Behold the Multiverse like a nerd?
Yep.
Gotcha. Okay, okay.
That one can go to the bottom. I like that. This one, though.
Okay, okay. Bring it on. Ari Lax against the world.
Okay, I'll play. Let's play an island.
Okay.
And pass a turn.
Untap. Upkeep. A draw. Chapter 3. Yep. I will target Nico Aris.
That's fine. Still on your draw step, I will soul sear the Nico.
Okay, well, you didn't let me pick loyalty or,
Plus one, plus one.
Yeah, I think I will pick loyalty now. Okay, yep, it's dead. Okay, rude. Now, let's go with beatdowns.
I got a 12.
And here, now that I'm ahead on board, I just kind of want to keep pressing my advantage. So I'm going to start with the Birth of Mellitus, the most powerful play I could possibly do.
Yep.
Get a Plains. Oh my, do I not have... Oh, I don't have another Plains!
Okay. Nice.
Well, I cannot cast. Well, I guess I already did, so... I'm going to say I needed that Plains to cast my thing, but I guess I'll cast something else. All right, good job, Corey. Good job.
Only four Plains in the deck?
Yeah, that's usually enough.
Yeah.
Usually don't draw
So chat's telling us that apparently you get to activate the... You might have a chance to activate the Planeswalker because of when the effect happens. I'm not sure if that's true or not.
Oh, yeah, it's in your main phase, yeah.
Oh, yeah, it is in the main phase. That changes everything.
Back everything up here. Back it all up. All right, so, yeah, Chad's totally right.
Okay, you have an eco.
Okay, so...
I'm at 20.
Yeah. Good job, Chad. You saved me from my Birth of
Mellitus. It always feels like it's a draw step, but it's not.
Yeah, okay. So I don't want to return one of my angels to play. I do not want to deal 2 damage to any tapped creature, so I will start by getting a shard. Okay, and then beginning combat?
Yep.
All right, attack.
Okay, I'll make a 5/5 shard.
All right.
I'll block one of the angels.
Okay. That's probably worse for me.
I'll go to 16.
Okay. I feel like I got there somehow.
you then immediately make the shard pre-combat, so now you can't just... I guess this isn't tap.
I do have a Dream Trawler, then.
That's not good.
And I have this, and I'll pass to you.
At least the shark can tag the Dream Trawler.
Yeah, it can.
Although, apparently we made it worse now.
What?
Nico does have an ETB trigger, right? Does that happen if you don't spend the mana?
Create X shards. X would be 0 because it's just coming back.
But it still might create a trigger that I could have responded to before you got the shard, right?
Oh, that's what they're saying.
Right.
Whatever. We're sticking with this now, Chad.
Yeah.
It's day one. We're all going to mess it up.
We're sticking with this.
Chad's arguing with itself.
You only get one backup per turn.
Yeah.
You only get one.
Too bad, Chad. You're going to like it.
Let's play an island.
Okay.
And... Soulseer the Nico.
Okay.
Unfortunately, the first mistake we ever made here.
First mistake. Yeah. First mistake. This is a new one.
And pass the turn.
Okay. Okay. Well. Let's see what we want to do. 5, 6. So 5/5 shark is annoying, and I can imagine you have a counter spell.
I didn't have one for the Amirius call, so.
That's true. Well, how about we start with this? I'm going to sack this. Scry. I probably want that card, even though it doesn't help me out of this little bind. That is a toughie. Yeah, I think I'll keep that. And...
Five in hand now, or four?
Yeah, five. Let's go with declare attack, trigger.
Yep.
And yeah, you can block. Still think I just want to be jamming threats, but yeah, this is going to happen. So
gain six,
go to 21.
Yep, so we got 21 to 16.
And I'm going to play a triumph and pass to you.
On your end step, I will draw a card.
Okay.
Tome. Go to my turn.
Yep.
I will play a Temple of Epiphany.
Okay.
Oh, that's an interesting card.
Interesting.
Yeah, I'll leave that one on top.
Okay.
Pass.
I'll make a 4/4 shark.
Yep.
I got sharks too, Ross. You killed my angel? Well, it's coming back. All right, untap.
Yep.
Draw. All right. 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. I have an Amirius call.
I have a mystical dispute.
That's rude. I have a negate.
I have...
Tears?
No, it's getting counter. I just got to figure out what. It'll be with a mystical dispute.
Okay. I'll attack for 8.
I will go to 8.
Pass to you.
And step, I'll draw a card and go to 12.
Okay. I drew the best possible card in my deck. Oh, yeah. All right, 2 4/4s and a prayer.
How about 0 4/4s? Shatter Skull Smashing for 6.
You got 2 red there? Oh, okay. All right, well, rude. Very rude.
And attack for 1.
Okay,
you're 20. 20. So we got 20 to 12, pass the turn.
All right.
This is a big turn.
Yes, it is.
Don't destroy me, please.
I will try to.
This all emanated from that one turn where Corey resolved the angel.
Yep. All right, I'm going to foretell.
Sure.
I will cast this.
Sure.
Okay. I think this is something I want to keep, at least the top card. Yeah, we'll keep this top one. We'll put that bottom one down, draw 2.
You can't cast it and foretell it on the same turn.
Oh, really?
You're foretell then cast it. You just have to just cast it.
Oh, cast it on a later turn. Okay, well, I was mostly just memeing. I would have just cast it, but yeah, I didn't know that. That makes sense, though. That makes sense. So I am just casting it. I was just trying to be cute.
Why does that make sense? It's just kind of weird.
Yeah, I don't know.
You're foretelling something. It's coming later.
That's true.
It's just a flavor thing, yeah.
That's true. Okay, then end step, I'll play second main, Nico Urs for two.
I will negate.
Lame. Okay, pass to you.
Okay, that went very well for me.
Yep. I feel bad about that.
I am going to play River Glide Pathway, get in for one.
19,
and then I will play a Bone Crusher Giant.
Okay.
Pass the turn.
All right. I don't mind the Bone Crusher, because I have an ECD.
I will rewind that.
Rewind? I will negate that.
I will Thassa's Intervention negate for two.
All right. That all happens.
Untap four lands.
I'll play a Bertha Mellitus, and I will not search, and I'll pass to you.
Attack for five.
14.
Play a mountain and pass.
Okay. I got this. Now, hoping you're out of gas. I have an ECD.
Resolves.
Okay, exile your thing. And I have a Nico Urs for one.
Resolves.
All right.
I flooded a little bit here.
Yeah, and then I will destroy this.
Yep.
Pass to you.
I'm going to bounce the wall and play Brazen Borrower.
Dang it. Step. Okay.
Attack Nico.
Nico's dead.
And it's possible I needed to draw cards with the Thassa's Intervention earlier, but
done.
Seems like, yeah, you're good.
Okay. How good's that card?
Good enough.
Dang it. Okay. This is on chapter two. No. How big of a shark could you make if you top deck that?
10-10.
10-10. Okay, that's not cool.
Exactly not enough.
Oh, this gain life now. Sure. Aha!
You're at 16.
Okay, let's go with... All right, let's cast Epiphany.
Resolves.
All right. 2-1-1s. Then also I will crack this. Scry. Yeah, I'll keep this as an insurance policy. Untap.
Yep.
Draw. I think I want Dreamy Tea.
That's what I was expecting.
Yeah. I'll put that Dream Trawler into play. That's kind of, honestly, the best part of Dream Trawler in this matchup is just letting it get countered, you know?
I almost want to bring in Soul Guide Lantern just to stop ECDs.
Yeah, right.
I go to 10.
10, and then I will pass to you.
Pass to you.
Big shark. 4, 5, 6, 7. 7-7 shark. Nom, 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 nom. This game slipped away from you, Ross, when it looked real good. Draw, trigger. Go with the Teferi.
Sure.
I will draw. And discard this Bertha Mellitus. Declare attacks.
Yep.
Trigger.
Yep. So you've drawn for turn, drawn off Teferi, drawn off this.
Yep.
So it's a 7.
Yep.
Just trying to figure out how big I want my shark to be.
Okay.
Do you have the Borrower?
I do. I have it all.
I need to draw a negate.
Well, I can do it with the trigger on the stack. Nine. I guess you can stack it correctly.
Yeah, you stack the triggers.
All right, and, but I have a dispute as well.
Yeah, I would make a 9-9. I was drawing a dispute, which isn't good enough.
Yep. All right, force the game 3. Woo.
Yeah, I wonder if the Maze Mind Tomes on my sideboard should be something a little bit more overtly powerful.
I think the Maze Mind Tome there was good.
It was good, but I needed some late game punch. Like, I didn't really use it early.
Yeah.
Instead, I tried to use it early a little bit to scry for cards I needed to not fall behind.
Yeah.
That didn't really work.
Yeah, you know, I feel like scrying and control mirrors are like almost never worth it.
Probably just to hit land drops, which I didn't need. I kept a 5 lander, which is great. You definitely want that in the control mirror, but just kind of ran out of gas. You know, you had 9 lands, I had 12 at the end, and the extra 3 cards.
Yeah, and the one nice thing I have an advantage of you is 6 of my lands are big spells, and one of them resolved.
Yeah.
You know, actually 2 of Miria's calls resolved. You know, you dealt with all of them, but 2 of them did resolve.
Well, no, one of them got countered, but you still traded a land for a spell.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's actually what is a big deal.
Yeah.
You know, I guess I had a Shatter Skull as well, so one of my lands was a spell.
Yeah.
But not nearly as good as Amiri's Call.
Yep, pretty solid. All right, Rob, you got a question while we shuffle up for a third game of round one?
Yeah, we had a question earlier about what you all think about the new 5-mana dragon that is coming in the set. I don't know if y'all have seen
Did you see this?
Yes.
I think this card is good.
Yeah.
It's a 5-mana 4/4 flying haste, right?
Yep.
We've already seen that be insane in Glorybringer.
Well, in so many, like Glorybringer, there was, what was the one before it?
The one that like dealt 1 to everything or something?
Thunder Mahalkai.
Thunder Mahalkai.
The 5/5. There have been a bunch of big flying dragons, you know, over the last 10 years.
Yeah.
So, and then, you know, I like this one quite a bit too. Like when it gets targeted by a spell or ability, you get a treasure, right?
Also, when it attacks.
When it attacks.
And treasures add double.
Yes.
Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, you can like attack with it and then use 2 mana to do something like
Scorching Dragonfire or Fire Prophecy.
Even in your deck, I mean, if you went a little bit more of an aggressive slant, like Petty Theft or Brazen Bar or Bone Crusher, maybe a transitional sideboard option for you in some matchups would be kind of cool.
If I'm able to, play it, attack a Planeswalker down, get a treasure, and then either Petty Theft Stomp, like you said, or even Negate or Essence Scatter.
Yeah. Or better yet, think about if you play that on turn 5 attack, maybe it lives, maybe it doesn't, and then let's say, they kill it the next turn, so you have 2 treasures. Next turn you just like Gadwick or something, that could be spicy.
Yeah.
All right.
That card I like quite a bit. You will be seeing it next week for sure.
Definitely. If we would have been able to play with it now, we would have.
Yeah.
That card's busted.
Okay. I am on the play for this game, and I will keep my hand.
I'll keep my hand, too. Let's do it.
I will play Island and pass.
All right. All right. I have a castle, and I'll pass.
Mountain Fortel.
You would.
You're up.
That was a pretty good draw. I will take 3 and play the Birth of Miletus. And pass to you.
So you're at 17. Play an island and pass a turn.
Okay. Now this is a turn where normally people would be like, he has 3 mana. This is probably not a good time to play something into a counter spell. But you can also just play this spell if I don't do anything. So there is some incentive to playing just because of that.
And when you know they have a proactive play.
Exactly. So I'm going to play this.
Halfway.
Yep. I'm going to go with the Mistgate side. And I'm going to go with Nico Aris.
I will respond with Behold the Multiverse.
Okay. Yeah, I could get Dispute as well, which is busted. Just kind of get your cake and eat it too.
This is a tough decision. I am not sure.
Okay.
You have 6 cards in hand?
6 cards.
I'm going to take both of them and dispute your Nico.
All right. Pass to you. That is the worst case scenario, is having the dispute instead of negate.
Then I will play a Jawari Ruins.
Okay.
And pass the turn.
Untap, I will gain 2.
Brings you to 19.
Yep. Drew that, and we'll have a nice boring turn of land go.
On your end step, I will stomp you.
How dare you?
17.
stomping your friends like this on a Friday, of all things.
I don't know. Let's play a Bone Crusher.
Okay.
Pass the turn.
I'll make a 2-2 shark. A draw. Untap. A draw. Okay. See what we want to do. I'll attack for two.
I'm at 18.
And I think I just want to try to make sure I hit land drops here. So I'm going to go with Birth of Miletus.
That's fine.
Okay. Get a Plains. What else do I want to do? You're likely doing nothing this turn or next turn. I don't really want to do too much either. So I think I'm just going to play the Seagate Restoration tapped and pass to you.
Attack for four.
A block.
That's what I thought.
This thing does not do much.
River Glide Pathway, pass the turn.
All right. I'll untap, gain two.
Brings you to
19. Yep.
Oh, no. You're skipping steps. You get a wall first.
Oh, yeah. I just did that. That's right.
Yeah.
I was like, I feel like I just left that in play. So I'm still at 17.
Yeah.
17, 18, right?
Yeah, the wall has gained four life, though, so that's even better.
Even better has been declared.
By me. Just now.
By Ross.
You were there.
Okay, let's go with an attack for two.
16.
And kind of want to try to play something. Don't want to just give you a big shark turn. I will just pass to you.
Yeah, I'll make a 4-4 shark.
Okay.
Go to my turn.
Yep.
Play Mountain. Attack for eight.
I am going to Petty Theft the Shark.
I will negate your Petty Theft.
I will negate your negate.
I will negate your negate.
All right. That all works.
Take an eight.
No, I'll block.
Oh, you got that. Sure. So you got a 13?
13, yep.
Okay, I will pass the turn.
All right, up to 15. Draw. Now we're going to go with ECD.
That resolves.
Take care of that. The question of do I want to attack a 2-2 shark into this shenanigans? I don't think I really want to block, so I'll attack.
I go to 14?
Yep, 14, 15. I'll play the Samiria land tapped and pass to you.
You have two in hand?
I have two in hand. Three. Or I have three in hand, sorry.
Attack for four.
11.
Stomp the shark.
Okay.
Play Bone Crusher and Foretell.
Okay.
I think Corey's going to go for something this turn anyway, and I don't have a counter spell, so do your worst.
All right. I will draw.
Make I thought about foretelling more. Last turn, but I wanted to represent a 3-mana counter spell.
Yeah, that's fair. Let's see. Okay. Well, actually, I have a pretty cute play. It's not insanely good or anything, but it's definitely cute. So I got a Nico Aris, and I'm for sure going to do it for one, because then I can kill the shark. I'm seeing how much I don't think I've played a land this turn, though, because I didn't have one last turn. So I for sure
Yeah, but you could like play it for three and just
get. I think I do want to play it for three. Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, not bad.
Three shards. Then I'm going to pop one and.
Pop one. Scry.
Shark.
I do think I want this. Yeah. I'll take this and then pass to you.
And now I can attack the Nico, but that is going to let Corey rebuy it with the ECD and have it with four loyalty. So it's essentially, do I value two loyalty on Nico or...
I mean, I get a brazen if you...
Or the four... Or,
you know,
the
I could just...
Brazen bar.
I don't have to get Nico here. I can just get a 4-2 flyer. Not that powerful, but, you know, it's a thing.
Definitely a thing. So that is a question of which I would prefer Corey to have. And you're at 11 right now?
11 to 14. Yeah, that's shaping up to be a good game.
And three cards in hand?
Three cards, yep. And the nice thing is I can deal two damage to the Bone Crusher. Don't take two damage with Nico.
I am going to attack the Nico.
Nico's dead.
Pass the turn.
Okay. Untap.
Draw.
Chapter 3. I will pick Nico. Loyalty. Anything with the shard trigger on the stack?
You're good.
Okay. I bet I can -2 hold priority and do this, right? To guarantee the ability.
I think so.
Because you can do that with, you know, other spells.
Yeah. I think you can do that.
Yeah.
Which means I want to respond to this ability.
I'm sorry, we're already in my main phase.
Yeah, this is, we're in your main phase with this trigger on the stack.
Oh, I'm sorry, I just said that trigger resolves. I see what you were planning there.
Yeah. Yeah, so I guess with that trigger on the stack, do we know if this trigger goes on the stack, if it's going to be for zero? Sometimes it doesn't. I'm never sure anymore.
Yeah, I don't know.
It doesn't have an intervening if, though, so I think it does. That's normally like it has to have the intervening if, like Oath of Druids and a lot of other cards.
Yeah.
With the trigger on the stack, let's answer that.
Okay. I will go for a Mystical Dispute.
So I will pay 3.
All right, dispute it again.
Yeah, that's not great.
Okay, so it's in my draw step. I already...
Well, this is your main phase.
Yeah, I already drew.
For turn.
So yeah. I am going to do... I think we can do this. I'm going to target this, but then with that ability on the stack, just to guarantee no funny business, I'll keep this, and then I'll pass to you. Go, Nico, go! You're doing things! We don't have to be that meme at the end, be like, do something.
Yeah.
Do something.
Land go.
Okay.
Yeah, Nico has looked very good.
Yeah, not bad.
I'm regretting. I guess there was no point where I could actually fully deal with it before you untapped.
Yeah, I don't think there was. Well,
you have 4 in hand now.
I have 4 in hand. Now it's just a question of what do I want to do.
Can this be the game where you float out and have 12 lands?
No.
Four lands in hand, please.
It is not. It is not that game. Okay, so let's go with... I'm going to make a shard. And... I'm going to pass to you.
On your end step, I'll make a 6/6 shark. Okay. So awkward that, like, I kind of wanted to do other things, but I need to make it 6/6 to play around your shark. Yep. Go to my turn.
Yep.
Not bad. I will attack Nico.
Now the question, I have a shark typhoon as well, and now it's a question if I want to go for 6 to trade or like a baby shark to block.
Yeah. Chump or trade.
Yep. Because the cute thing, if Nico lives, I can sack 2 and then deal 6 to it, yeah. You know? But I think it's quite risky. Brazen Bar is quite bad for me as well, but I don't think there's much I can do. I'm going to go for a 6/6.
Okay, I've got the Brazen Bar.
Uh-oh.
Well, Petty Theft that.
Okay, this is dead.
And Nico is dead, so that went well.
Yeah.
I will then play a Temple of Epiphany.
Okay.
I will put that on, leave that on top and pass the turn.
Ugh. Okay.
I'm feeling better.
I'm not. All right. I mean, I have to play a very good spell regardless this turn, but
Birth of Mellitus.
Birth of Mellitus. That's the start.
Resolves. It looks like you got one more planes.
Exactly. All right. I'll play that. And God, which spell do I even go for? They're all not even that great, unfortunately. All right, Time Walk.
Yeah, I'll counter that.
Lame. Okay, Bastio.
Play Brazen Bar on end step.
Okay. Am I dead?
Let's see.
You know the card.
Oh, yeah, I knew that one. That one doesn't kill you.
Okay.
Yeah, attack you for 9.
Okay, I'm down to 2.
I will play Behold the Multiverse.
Okay.
Ooh. You aren't getting a wall next turn?
Yep.
I have the Crawling Barons, which is like hard for you to deal with, and you're low on life.
Yeah.
I think I just need other things. Yeah. Both on the bottom.
Okay.
Land for turn.
Okay.
Scry. Yeah, we gotta leave that on top, I think.
Okay.
And play Maze Mind at home.
Sure.
Pass the turn.
All right, I will get a wall. Don't think that's going to help me. Well, I have one play that for sure keeps me alive if it resolves, but it's not exciting. Yeah, all right. Well, we'll go for that. I have a Dream Trawler.
Draw with Tome in response.
Okay.
Neutralize Dream Trawler.
All right, I'm dead. Yeah, I mean, I really thought I had you there, but going for that huge tempo loss of me sharking, and I mean, I had Brazen Bar, so I could have done what you did and just Petty Theft this immediately.
Yeah.
Instead, I tried to Petty Theft during your turn to make you tap out to then do something, but it just didn't work out well. It didn't work out the way I wanted it to, yeah. You know? And yeah, it got me good.
Yeah, Shark Typhoon is great.
Yep.
Squeak that one out. That was a great match.
I
do think I could benefit from some like scalable threat, like Gadwick. It would be my version of Nico, right?
Yeah.
I think I needed something like that to scale into the late game, because once we get to the late game and we're a little bit depleted on resources, I need to counter all your big spells.
You do.
Because Dreamcrawler and Nico
are
all really good, and you still have the Shark Typhoons and the cheap counters that I have to navigate post-board.
Yep.
Pre-board, you're usually so light on threats that I'm able to just counter all the relevant stuff.
Yeah.
That's what we saw happening game one. But post-board, it was just so much scarier when you just got a little bit of that flash element. So I needed to add a little bit of your element, that powerful tap-out stuff.
Agreed. And for me, the thing that I have the biggest takeaway from this match is Nico was probably in the matchup where it's supposed to be the worst, because you're all flash threats. you know, it's blue, so you can dispute it. You know, your deck is very well set up to deal with my 3-mana Planeswalkers, and it was still good.
Yes.
So I have a lot of hopes that if I'm playing against, like, a green deck, and I can go, like, you know, Nico, kill your one threat, and they go something, I go shatter and then make a shard or something, I'm just like, this is going to be... I think that card's going to be very good.
Yeah,
so.
Impressed by Nico, impressed by Behold the Multiverse. So yes. Both the cards we were really looking at looked quite good.
The Time Walk is good, too, but that's 7-mana. It's going to be a powerful card when you cast it. So,
yeah, exactly. Yeah. Impressive stuff all around to start.
I like it. Okay, so that was kind of our, I don't want to say boring, but that was the matchup where it was going to be a grind, right? Yeah. Like, so we wanted to start with this, get that out of the way. Now we got some really, really exciting decks coming up. Next up, I'm going to be playing Mono Green, and we got a decent amount of toys. I think I had 11 new cards in this Mono Green deck. Yeah. So
Corey's playing an aggro deck, and I, as you all expect, am playing a Yorian deck with a lot of different colors.
Is it? Oh, I know why. It's Freaky Friday! Woo! All right, everyone, we're going to take a short 5-minute break, and we'll be right back here on Freaky Friday on Versus Live.